Good morning all. This is an 8S BMS. It's specifically a LiFePO4 8S BMS. I bought it on eBay from a chap in the UK for £99. Quite expensive, but then it is 100 amps. Look at those ring terminals. So what's this thing got? Well, two monster great power cables, or high current cables. There are two temperature sensors here, which run into two pin JSTs on the side. It's supplied with this, which is a Bluetooth dongle, I suppose, which plugs into that socket there. And it also comes with a 9-way cable, which is actually curiously soldered into a 11-way header. So I suppose they're using a common PCB for a 10S BMS and an 8S BMS, and they've just left a couple of gaps in here. And in fact, if you look on the underside of this board, there's a couple of solder bridges where they've bridged those gaps. But anyway, this is the 8S BMS. Let's power it up and see what it does. The thing is, I don't really want to disturb the 8-cell LiFePO4 battery pack that I've got in the shed and bring it all in here and disconnect everything. So I was thinking, is there a simpler way I could test this? So I was thinking about these sorts of things, these LiPo testers, particularly these LED ones. Now, as I remember it, these are powered from the first two cells. And of course, that makes sense because although this can check 8 voltages on 9 pins, it works just as well on a 2S or 3S battery. In fact, here's a 3S battery pack. So let's just check this out. That's negative there. Oh, that's very loud. So that's saying a 3CS, whatever that means. And it shows you the number 1, number 2, and number 3 voltages, and then all, and then back to number 1. So this needs to be powered from the low end pins in case you are not using an 8S pack. So I was just wondering whether that might possibly apply to this. But then I thought, no, this is sort of nice and professional. And also, it's only intended to work with 8 cells. So I'm supposing that this is probably going to take its power, you know, for the microcontroller and all the circuitry, from the red and black on here, which are the outer extremes of this connector. So on that assumption, I need to find something with 8 cells that's going to make this fire up, and we can look at the app on a device and do it through Bluetooth and all that stuff. And then I thought, what about this? 9 cells. Yeah, they're supercapacitors, and yeah, they only go up to 2.7 volts. But if I charge this thing fully, solder these wires onto, well, 8 of these capacitors across 8, that's 9 wires, charge this up to the top, this will see it and this should power up. It'll be about 21 volts or something like that. It's going to show that all the cells are very low, but that doesn't matter. It just gets the thing running. I just want to see if this works. Check out the app and see what sort of features it has. So let's do this. I've got my buck boost there. I can put my 12 volts in there. Yeah, my 12 volt battery still seems to be working. Oh, in fact, it's 12.5. I can take a thing off there. Now, I found this in my box of lithium stuff, so that can go into those. And then if I put an XT60 on there, I don't think I now bother with anti-backfeed diodes to protect the power supply, because I've never had an issue with that. So I think we can hook this thing up directly to the output of this power supply. Charge this thing up, probably take those bulbs off, solder all the wires of this onto the pos of each of these caps, oh, and the most negative round here, and see if that BMS works. Let's get going. So XT60s and 90s, I can see these are going to get used up quite quickly, but like I say, I ordered 10 sets of these and the chap gave me 15 for some bizarre reason, not complaining. So that will plug into there, so I just need to put a couple of spade terminals in there and have it hang off the back end of there. Let's do it. I've put a couple of spade terminals in there, and now pos is the flat side, isn't it, on here. So if I just shove that on there and solder it, that's it. Simples. Right, that's soldered onto there. So I can now, well, I'll just check this. I've set it to 26 volts, 1 amp, so that'll charge that up. But what I really want to do now is solder these 9 wires onto the supercap block, ignoring the last capacitor. Don't know whether you remember, but this one had a lazy cap, which is always slow to come up, so I've got extra connections on there to sort of experiment with it. But that, well, that could be quite interesting, actually, if it's a bit slow to come up. BMS should show that on its graphical user interface. Well, I've started to solder the wires on, but now I'm just thinking, what's the sequence of these? I think it is these three, but then it seems to go over there, and then it seems to go over there. So does it go in a funny wiggle? I don't know. Perhaps I'll charge it to, I don't know, half a volt and measure some points on here. Well, that is 72 millivolts. That's 300 millivolts. Oh, that's not very easy, is it? Right, that's the wires on. I've decided to use the power supply to charge it to 9 volts. That's 1 volt per capacitor. And that'll make it a bit easier to just run along here and see that they're all in sequence. Right, that's nearly at 9 volts, 8.6. Let's go across these. 0.9, 1.8, 2.8, 3.8, 4.89, 5.8, 6.8, 7.8. Yes, of course, it's 9 volts over 9 capacitors, so the top one will be 8 volts. Okay, looks like I've got them in the right sequence. Let's plug it in to the BMS. Okay, live on camera. Now, there is only 9 volts across there, or 8 volts across here, so it's very low, but it might fire up the microcontroller. Of course, it might all explode. That's the other possibility. It doesn't actually say, it says BC naught there next to, and 0, yeah, so that's definitely negative. Let's plug it in and see what happens. Oh, it's quite tight, that. Well, that's plugged in. Interesting. Well, I suppose I should plug in the Bluetooth dongle, which I think has a little LED on it. Let's see if that lights up. That goes in there. No, it doesn't light up, so let's take the voltage across this further up. 12 volts, that still hasn't illuminated. There's plus on that. V bus is the red wire, that looks about right. So I don't know whether it needs close to the 24 volts to burst into life, but it ain't doing anything just yet. I'll leave it for a bit. Well, now to nearly 22 volts, still no light on this, but maybe that's an activity light rather than a power LED. No LEDs on the BMS, so nothing really to see. So I suppose I should go and get the app, which I've installed on my tablet, and see if it can see it. Right, can it see anything? Oh, I've switched off the power supply. Let's turn that back on. Signal very weak. Oh, strong. Let's pick that one. Use GPS to test speed. GPS? No. Oh. Well, that doesn't tell me a lot, does it? What's in here? Dashboard. Okay, that was that. Battery state. Whoa! Average voltage, 0.19. That's weird. Parameter view. Params loading. Well, I don't really know my way around this yet, so perhaps, oh, that's not very visual, is it? Param setting. So there's a lot of things you can set. Anyway, it seems to be talking to it. I'll have a bit of a play and come back. Well, this seems to be a problem. We've got battery voltage here and they're all measuring 0.1 volts. Well, that's not quite right. The lazy cap hasn't actually come up yet. I don't know whether that's going to be visible, but it has all the little LEDs are on all the other eight caps, but the bad one, the LED hasn't come on yet. So perhaps I'll wait for that to come on, but I don't know whether there's some sort of refresh. Maybe just pulling the plug out and rebooting it might be the answer. We'll see. Yeah, I'm still struggling a bit. Don't quite understand this, but I have found this graph, which is a current graph actually. It shows current at zero. And on the voltage line, voltage is blue there. It shows it went up to 13.6 very briefly and then came back to zero or very near zero. Actually, it's a negative. No, it's not negative. It's 1.5. Still don't quite know what's going on. One possibility when I'm measuring continuity between B minus on the blue wire and the zero point on the 10-way or 9-way connector, there's no continuity there. So do I have to connect this to the most negative point on the battery? They're not linked like they were on that daily BMS. So I'm going to link them. I'm going to link there, which is the most negative point on the battery. Wait for the spark. No spark. To there. And plug this in again and see if that changes anything. Let's find out. Ah, that's done it. And there is my lazy capacitor. And I can see the voltage of it now. So that's interesting. Unlike the daily BMS, there doesn't seem to be any intrinsic within the unit connection between B minus and the balance leads. They're kind of floating with respect to most negative point ground on here. Now I've got some voltages. That looks a bit more like it. Not sure why that one's flickering on and off, but there we are. Oh, I think that's telling me the lowest and the highest. So the highest is 2.686 and the lowest is 2.406. I think I should probably wait for the lowest one to come up. I'm sure it will. But yeah, that we're getting there. Now there's an absolute mass of parameters here. Overvoltage 3.65. Overvoltage release 3.5. Overvoltage release delay 2 seconds. Undervoltage 2.5. Undervoltage release 3. So it needs to drift back up to 3. Undervoltage release delay 2 seconds. Pack overvoltage 29. Pack overvoltage release 28. Pack overvoltage release delay 2 seconds. I mean, there's just masses of it, and I could scroll up. And there's masses more. There's so much stuff in here. It's crazy. And in the basic pack information, 21.13, that's very low for 8S lithium iron phosphate. There's no current, of course. It's an 8S pack. Average voltage is 2.64, but one of the cells is still very low. As a result of that, the charging switch is on and the discharge switch is off. So you can't discharge this pack. But I can charge it. I mean, I'm charging it anyway, separately through these banana plugs. Temperature number, there are two of them. Ah, they're both reading correctly now. 22.3 and 22.5. Date, no cycles. Nominal capacity, I suppose we can set that. Remaining capacity, nothing. Percentage capacity, 0%. Version and cell overvoltage, no. Interesting. Now, I did see that there's a newer version of this app, and from watching Off-Grid Garage, it looks prettier and everything's on one page. So I'm going to attempt to install that. I can't even remember how I installed this. You don't download it from the Play Store. You have to install it from an APK file, I believe it is. I'll give that a go, and that'll give Cell 2, which is my lazy capacitor, time to come up. I'll do that now. Yeah, this version of the app is a bit prettier. That's an ammeter. Voltage, total voltage, temperature, probably the average of the two sensors. And it says that the charging FET is on, the discharge FET is off. And it shows these cells as much more empty this time, but the voltages are all there. So I'll head into some parameters, I think. And this is quite nice. I can turn off the charging FET, or FETs, there are a lot of them. And that stays. I can turn it back on for charging. I'm not hitting it properly. But if I try to turn on the discharge, it turns itself back off because it doesn't like cell 2, and neither do I. There are some voltages here for different percentages. 80% 3.329, 60% 3.322, 40% 3.291, and 20% 3.266. Well, I'm down at 2.6 volts, so it's obviously showing it as 0%. Well, there's clearly a huge amount of stuff you can do with this. If I go into parameter settings, there are 52 parameters I can change. I mean, that's a huge number, all sorts of stuff. I suppose I ought to first write down all the parameters that are preset into this. Actually, there probably is a reset parameters button somewhere so that you can reset all to defaults. In fact, I think I'll look for that. Well, there are some preset parameter sets. So if I do polymer light, we've got 4.2, polymer normal 4.25, LiFePO4 normal 3.65, and LiFePO4 light 3.6. Now I could lower the under voltage. So let's do LiFePO4 light, that's 2.75. Let's go for something like 2.5. And then I think I press the tick to set it. But I also want to change the low setting for the percentages. Where are they? Oh, I think they're under there. Where are the percentages? Yeah, here. So I want to set this 20% voltage really low so that it shows something on the bar graphs. So let's go for something like 2.5. No, missed. 2.5. And what did I set my low voltage to? It's in there somewhere. 2.5. So let's say that's okay. It appears to be writing the parameters into the unit. I can always go back to the previous settings, I think. I don't know, actually. And let's have a look at the home screen. Oh, it doesn't seem to have changed the percentage indicators here. Oh, well. So now I've turned off the power supply to charge the capacitors, so they're discharging. And we're down to 13.3 on the pack. And I'm kind of waiting until, I don't know, the microcontroller just stops measuring properly. That dodgy capacitor is really bad. Everything else at 1.8 and that's gone down to 0.47. I was thinking I might shift it actually from that position up to the top position just for this, but I can see how this works from this experiment. I mean, obviously I'm not seeing the percentages very accurately, but yes, I just think this is a bit over the top for my current LiFePO4 setup with the antminer and the solar connection. It does far more than I need it to do. I mean, it's massively configurable, but I just don't think it's appropriate for the simple setup I've got in the shed. So I'll sit on this for a bit, and maybe if I build a more complex and bigger setup, I might come back to this BMS, but it just seems a bit over the top for what I'm doing at the moment. But anyway, that was my first look at this £99 BMS. So for the moment, cheerio.